Just like that I can put it.
Yeah. That's
okay.
it, that's it.
And
Because
now
when
just like
there
that.
Are no chickpeas, get infection. If you keep long time.
Yeah.
Dzień dobry, witam wszystkich bardzo serdecznie. Chciałem dzisiaj zaprosić na film, gdzie pod okiem doktora Ashkara zmieniam opatrunek, żebyście zobaczyli, jak to się dzieje i co się dzieje. W międzyczasie podczytuję sobie książki doktora Ashkara w języku polskim i w języku angielskim. Nagrałem dosyć sporo materiału z doktorem Ashkarem, bo najprawdopodobniej jest to jego ostatnia wizyta w Polsce. I te wszystkie filmy, ten dokument, będzie na moim kanale Szlachetne Zdrowie. Jak ogarnę to wszystko, jak się nauczę robić takie okienka polecające film i tak dalej. No jest jeszcze tam sporo rzeczy, których się muszę nauczyć, chyba że ktoś może mi podpowiedzieć, kto jest biegły w wrzucaniu i manewrowaniu filmikami, audycjami na YouTubie. Tutaj otworzyło mi się na stronie 19 i dr Ashkar pisze, że w 50 roku, 1950, zajmowało jakieś 40 lat, żeby się dorobić tego nowotworu jakiegoś złośliwego, który nas ukatrupi, a w latach 90 to już tylko 10-15 lat ze względu na potworną chemię w jedzeniu, być może smugi chemiczne i być może mnóstwo innych rzeczy, o których nie wiemy. I jak doktor Ashkar podkreśla, chemioterapia jest po prostu powolnym zabijaniem człowieka. Zapraszam na audycję.
You enjoyed Poland?
Oh, definitely.
Yes.
Otherwise I wouldn't come.
Ah.
Oh, this is 10th year.
10th year.
I started
I know in
2009.
2009, yeah.
This is the last one. 10 years.
Okay, so we'll change, zmienimy opatrunek i doktor Ashkar będzie mówił, czy wszystko jest robione w porządku. So you will check if everything is all right.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm taking the bandage out. I changed it this morning, early morning.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see how the wound looks. There is still blood coming.
Oh, you see? Well, very good.
Very good.
Working normal.
Working normal,
yeah. That's working normal.
And this readiness is?
It's going, yeah, it will go, what is here, make this color. When it gets out, the same color will be here.
Ah, okay.
On this temporary.
So we'll have to?
Yeah.
Take it out.
Uh-huh. And clean. Usually, you know what to do before taking out. Clean around.
Oh, clean. I haven't got anything to clean, so we'll do
okay.
cleaning. But normally, you, oh, the blood is coming.
Yes.
Quite a lot.
Uh-huh.
Is that okay?
So yeah,
sometimes
yeah.
Sometimes blood is coming.
If chickpeas coming out easily, this blood is infected. Must be come out.
Ah, so keep it flowing for some
yeah,
time?
Yeah, yeah, yes. Keep it, keep it. No problem.
There's no problem?
No. If it is... Sometimes coming like this, oh, sometimes coming like this, very thin, like water.
A.
Sometimes color is like jello.
Mamy tutaj coś niespodziewanego. Andrzej, przyniesiesz serwetki, bo dużo krwi upływa. Ale doktor Ashkar mówi, że to jest ok.
If he has
yes.
alcohol.
I trochę spirytusu. Ale doktor mówi, że jest ok, bo dużo krwi wylatuje.
Aha.
Ale to tak czasem.
Do you have a spiritus?
Da, da.
So it's ok, nothing to worry.
No, no, no.
Because some people, when see me like this before, no. they say, oh, it's gangrene coming, it's gangrene.
Oh, gangrene. If you have gangrene, we'll be cleaned out.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hmm. Because what is coming, that causing gangrene,
Ah,
coming out.
So this is infected blood.
Yeah,
and
in fact,
so it's nothing to worry.
Especially when it's like this, very like water.
It's lots of blood inside.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
Spiritus.
Okay. So we have to clean.
Yeah. Around.
Okay, but just around. Oh, mm-hmm. The blood stops now. So.
Yeah, that's so temporary. Yeah. That is infected yeah. blood must come out.
If the blood is coming, is coming nothing.
And through the blood coming a carcinogen also.
Nothing to worry.
No. I tell you, nothing to worry.
Yeah,
absolutely. Worry. Anything happens is normal.
Ah, yeah. Because the first week. And the important thing, always Dr. Ashkar repeat, we'll talk in English, then I translate it in Polish, uh-huh. is that it cannot be open for too long.
Yeah, exactly. Many's
so better to put the chickpeas
inside.
Inside, one, now.
Yeah.
Just like that I can put it.
Yeah. That's okay. That's it. And because when there are no chickpeas, get infection. Mm. If you keep long time.
Yeah, like for a day or something.
Even hours.
Even hour. So the get important infected. Thing is to because take out, put in, clean.
Yeah, exactly. Because chickpeas absorbs, get flow, establish flow from inside to outside. So infection, infection cannot go in because flow is outside.
At this moment cannot go in. So this is important point.
Absorbing now. Mm-hmm. And coming flow coming out, so infection cannot go in. If there are no chickpeas, infection goes in.
And to cover the wound, what I do, I cut it in half.
Yeah.
We'll show whoever is watching, because half will be enough.
Mm-hmm.
And then we can. Make a hole, not too big. So something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Put a leaf on.
Now put and tell that in the summer times you can leave, keep leaves.
We can, in the summertime, yes, or spring, or even autumn, we can use leaves like from the garden or whatever.
Like straight, you know, clean.
Straight, clean leaves, and always the not the outside, the inside, the active
on the
side.
Wound.
Yes,
on
the wound has to come, so we can. Yeah, you, too big.
Yeah, you can cut half.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Something like this will do. We'll put the side which inside which will
this
go
is,
into the wound.
You did this way.
I use this way. Are you using different way?
Yeah.
So maybe you show on another one.
Usually
we
like this.
Another leaf.
No. Usually make wound here.
Ah.
And put the leaves here.
Oh, no, you will show on.
You can do, you know, you can do this way also. Mm-hmm. Like, you put this here. Here?
Uh-huh.
This and this.
Oh, I see. But this
the important is this one.
Yes, yes.
Important.
So, but this is enough, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
This would be enough. So,
yeah, you like this, it's okay, no problem.
I prefer smaller, but someone can do bigger, according to. And that's it, we just, as long as chickpeas is in, so.
And you put this, is also?
Yes.
First time when you put the chickpeas, must be very careful, it will be in the middle of the wound.
Oh, in the middle, yes.
Now there are already make the wound
The wound is deep.
So you cannot make mistake.
But when you're starting the treatment.
Yeah, because there are no hole, you have to put exactly in the middle. But now you don't worry about because there are.
It's already, I'll keep, this is the May, June, July, August, almost 3 months will be.
It's
end
right.
of this month. Okay, thank you.
So, 6 months mandatory, must
yeah,
be.
Must be 6 months.
If still there are blood and pus, you have to continue until only water must come.
Only water, yeah?
Yeah.
So as long
not blood, no more.
Yeah, as long as blood is coming out,
you have to continue. You have to continue.
It has to be continued.
Yeah. Because if you close the wound, blood coming and you close the wound, then you get in trouble. You have to start again, everything.
Yes, yes. Some people complain about it. Yes.
It's better continue many months. It's much better than start again.
And the important thing is the bandage has to be quite tight.
Very tight.
Very tight.
If it is not tight, it will move and make pain.
Yes. And even sometimes chickpeas can come out during sleep,
sure,
which
sure.
can be dangerous.
When it's loose, yeah.
Yes.
Even if all night out, chickpeas is out, maybe heals the wound and you cannot use it.
Yes. Oh, yes. Danger, yeah.
Yeah.
So it has to be tight, this is tight. Important.
Some people are afraid tight because they said maybe the blood circulation is bad. Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
No, blood circulation is
now when I put
normal.
It tight, it's okay, but at the beginning, in the first few weeks, I have quite a lot of pain because the wound was just
a new wound, yeah.
A new wound. But not to worry. To worry about the pain.
No, no.
At the beginning.
No, now sometimes you forgot you have wound because there is no wound, there's no pain.
Yes. And you should drink a lot of liquids during the
It's up to you.
Yes?
Doesn't matter, yeah. The some important here, chickpeas must be inside all the time.
Yes.
And around clean. Around clean because liquid coming...
Chickpeas, yes.
Liquid coming from inside irritates the skin. That's the reason you have to clean up with alcohol. And don't delay, put dry one fast after taking. That's the reason I am saying first you clean up,
yes.
Then take out and put another one fast.
Okay.
And tight.
And tight. This is
elastic bandage.
Important thing. And not to leave the wound for longer than is necessary, like 1 minute.
Yeah, no. Second.
Immediately, just.
Yes.
Everything. And
normal.
And yes, just change quickly the chickpeas, take the old
because
one and put the new one.
Wound is not getting infection because of chickpeas. If there are no chickpeas, get infection. That's the reason you have to put fast chickpeas back in place to not get infection.
So even that some blood is coming out, as you can see,
it's
okay. It's quite normal and healthy.
Yeah,
even
because
the body
this blood is works. Infected blood, so must come out.
To była zmiana opatrunku. Jak widzicie, różne rzeczy się dzieją, ale to dobre rzeczy z tego wszystkiego, co wynika z tego materiału dokumentalnego. Mnie ta metoda pomaga, czuję się świetnie, czuję się dużo lepiej. To jest drugi miesiąc. Zobaczymy, jak będzie po 6 miesiącach i po dokładnych badaniach krwi, zwłaszcza wszystkich białych ciałek. I zobaczymy. Póki nie będzie tego mojego kanału Szlachetne Zdrowie, zapraszam do subskrybowania tego kanału, polecania znajomym, pisania, dzielenia się swoimi spostrzeżeniami. Ktokolwiek poddał się tej prostej, skutecznej terapii doktora Ashkara, która kosztuje może te 5-10 groszy na dziennie. Doktor Ashkar odradza wszystkim chemioterapię, która tak naprawdę jest powolnym uśmiercaniem, przeciąganiem nieuniknionej, przyspieszonej śmierci. A wystarczy zastosować tą metodę i możemy żyć w dobrym zdrowiu. Może jeszcze jakieś wyjmy na zakończenie z tomu czwartego. Jak zwykle Peter Sellers, znany wam być może brytyjski komik. Ja słyszałem o takim darze, ale uważałem, że to bujda, że to niemożliwe, żeby można było pisać pod dyktando jakiegoś ducha. Tak to Peter Sellers. I jeszcze Peter Sellers. Z życia poszczególnych ludzi łatwo jest wywnioskować, jak żyli w swoich poprzednich życiach. Jeżeli jakiś taki lekki szum tutaj słyszycie, to jest wiatrak, bo temperatura jest rzeczywiście bardzo wysoka dzisiaj, plus 30, a do tego żarówki, więc nic dziwnego, że się chłodzę. I na koniec Pier Paolo Pasolini. Ja za swego życia fizycznego akceptowałem to, co mi moja religia podawała. A no tak to jest, dopiero po śmierci dowiadujemy się, jak naprawdę jest. A już możemy się dzisiaj dowiedzieć z książek, z dyktowań ludzi w duchu do zapoznania, z którymi zapraszam. I do następnej audycji. Dziękuję, do miłego